Hello and welcome to the 7 o'clock news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Lebrek. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa today visited the Turkmen President Gurban Guly Berdimuhamedow at the Presidential Palace in Ashgabat. Upon arrival, His Majesty the King was received by the Turkmen President, who welcomed His Majesty, wishing him a pleasant stay. An official reception ceremony was held for His Majesty the King, and the two countries' national anthems were played. Then His Majesty the King inspected the Guards of Honor. His Majesty then greeted the ministers, senior officials, and diplomatic corps members accredited to Turkmenistan, while the Turkmen president greeted the members of the delegation accompanying His Majesty the King. Thank you.
الكريم جلالة الملك، أهلا وسهلا. أريد أن أتذكر أن زيارتي إلى مملكة البحرين تركت لي ذكريات حسنة.
Then His Majesty held a bilateral meeting with the Turkmen President, in which the President welcomed His Majesty the King and recalled his visit to the kingdom, expressing thanks and appreciation for His Majesty's visit, which carries considerable importance. The Turkmen President stated that commercial and economic relations will develop in light of the talks held between the Bahraini delegation and the Turkmen businessmen. He also expressed thanks and appreciation for His Majesty's support to develop bilateral relations, wishing Bahrain security and stability under the leadership of His Majesty the King.
نحن نعطي أهمية خاصة إلى زيارتكم الرسمية إلى تركمانستان، وسوف نحتفل بمناسبة الذكرى السنوية 25 بمناسبة إقامة وبداية علاقاتنا الدبلوماسية بإذن الله. نحن نطور علاقاتنا الصداقة مع دول الشرق الأوسط، ونهتم بتطوير هذه العلاقات، وفي جميع المجالات نحن نهتم بتطويرها مثل مجالات السياسة، الاقتصاد، والثقافة والإنسانية. في مجال السياسة نحن نشارك في دعم بعضنا بعضا في محافل الدولية، خاصة في إطار منظمة الأمم المتحدة. آراؤنا متشابهة ومتقاربة في موضوعات وفي قضايا الإقليمية والعالمية. في علاقاتنا التجارية والاقتصادية أيضا لها مستقبل كبير، وقبيل زيارتكم يعني قبل يوم أجريت منتدى رجال الأعمال التركمانستانية والبحرينية في أشقابات، وأجريت محادثات ومحادثات بناءة لتطوير العلاقات التجارية بين البلدين.
Yani ben bundan ya sizde de bizde de entel kullanmadık mümkünçlüklerde. Bilette bir de onu beyrettim. Hadan ve hadan harip dolanışın kopartmamışın olanlar tek olmayı.
إني على ثقة أن الإمكانات والفرص كبيرة غير مستفادة حتى الآن، فلذا يمكن أن نطور علاقاتنا التجارية، وأيضا نشارك في زيادة التبادل التجاري بين البلدين. في مجال الثقافة والإنسانية لنا مشتركات دينية وأخلاقية كثيرة، فلذا نحن نهتم بأن ندعم رجال الفن والثقافة والعلم والدراسة كي يتعاونوا بين البلدين ويدعموا لتوطيد العلاقات الثنائية بين البلدين.
ومن هرمتين دوغون هرمتين يخبان في نازنا ومن ثلاثة من التوكمين بخرين قطنس برمهان بيت تكتير شاكين غشون غشون ومدين من يتعرف.
أخي الكريم جلالة الملك، نعبر عن شكري الخاص شخصيا لكم لدعمكم ولمساعداتكم لتطوير العلاقات التركمانستانية والبحرينية. أتمنى للشعب البحريني الشقيق الازدهار والتطور والرخاء تحت قيادتكم الرشيدة. أهلا وسهلا في أرض إخوانكم التركمانستانيين، مرحبا بكم.
أنا أشكر فخامة الرئيس على دعوته الكريمه لنا.
Hürmetli Cenab-ı Prezident, ilk öğlen bizi Gözel Yurdu'nda çağırandığınız için size tüyüsürekten minnettarlık bildiriyor.
Ve isim الوفد المرافق كذلك مسجل اعجابنا بما راينا.
Özümüz yanımızda gelen vekiliyet bilen birlikte büyük yurtta bolup geçen yukarı derecelerde öyle görüştükler bizi büyükten hayranı kaldı.
Ve nü'lin an amel müşterek متقدم بإذن الله.
يتيب بعد جلسك تدأ بلالك ده بلوري على يوتلر مدي خلق المصر مع بلجة آدم آدات ويخدم التصوير.
نتيجة الثقة المتبادلة والأخوة اللي تربط القيادتين والشعبين.
بدي بيجن ريان ذات بدن خلق المدي ولن دولة المدي بيرك بيرك برلستر يعني أنام حكم سوريا شو بدهم شو يقرأن بخم ده.
والأهداف من هذا التعاون أهداف نبيلة.
بغات نشكلر من إثاث مقصدي قتي أجايب قوة مقصدر.
حكم القيادة الحكيمة لفخامة الرئيس والمشاعر اتجاهها في البحرين.
سيدن ألف باريان أمين سياسة من البحرين ندول سياسة المتطيار شو مشين بالبحرين ندول تحكم الناس اللي ملنها المقصد شو لأحميت.
والبحرين من زيارة فخامة الرئيس إلى اليوم تطورت تطوراً مضطرد.
بحرين دولتين سيدن بذا قلن شريت ميثاق النظام داري بذا دولو لبوشتر أما بوشتر بولك كشتي
خاصة في المجالات الطبية.
الله يتدى لقمان سلق الغمنا أولي بوشتر غدنا
لا شك تم فخامة الرئيس.
سيدن شين خاتم قدق لوالتغرك سيدن شين كتغن بنارمت.
وفي العلوم والجامعات
علمنا يقرأوا مكتب لردن وثشم قدور التلولي
البنية التحتية للبلاد
يعني يورد مضم شو الانفراستركتورة في تولى مقو بيركيا.
إن شاء الله يشرفنا بزيارة أخرى ليرى ما تم تحقيقه في الفترة الأخيرة.
بلو رأيت ما من ثبابي على جناب دوغون مثل ينا بريادك بحرين دولتنا شاعر مثل يعني شلو رياقين نقول رياض.
شكرا.
كبتاولا.
Then the open official talks between the two sides were held in the presence of the two countries' delegations. The Turkmen president delivered a speech in which he welcomed His Majesty the King and stated that memorandums of understanding will be signed between the two countries that will bolster cooperation and increase economic and investment exchange. His Majesty the King delivered the following speech.
شكرا فخامة الرئيس. أولا نشكركم على هذه الدعوة الكريمة وحفاوة الاستقبال وكرم الضيافة. نحن نستذكر باعتزاز زيارة فخامتكم إلى مملكة البحرين في فبراير 2011 ونحرص على متابعة ما تم التوصل إليه من اتفاقات وتفاهمات تدعم التقارب بين البلدين والشعبين كما نشيد بالعلاقات الأصيلة الراسخة التي تربط البلدين والقائمة على الاحترام المتبادل
والمصالح المشتركة، ونتطلع لتعزيزها وتطويرها في مختلف المجالات في ظل المقومات والإمكانيات الكبيرة المتواجدة، وننوه بأهمية تبادل الزيارات واستمرار التشاور حول كل ما من شأنه دفع أوجه التعاون الثنائي المثمر، ونرحب بالتوقيع على الاتفاقيات ومذكرات التفاهم خلال هذه الزيارة في المجالات الدبلوماسية والصناعية والتجارة والمال والنفط والغاز والتربية والتعليم والنقل والثقافة والسياحة والرياضة والحكومة الإلكترونية وغيرها. كما نؤكد على الاهتمام بتوسيع قاعدة التعاون التجاري والاقتصادي والاستثماري من خلال الاستفادة من الفرص المتاحة في كلا البلدين، وبحث إمكانية التعاون في قطاع النفط والغاز. كما نؤكد مرة أخرى على مواصلة تبادل الدعم والتنسيق المشترك في المحافل الدولية، مشيدين بوضع الحياد الدائم لتركمانستان، مما يعكس التزامها بالتنمية والأمن والسلم في منطقة آسيا الوسطى والعالم. كما يسرنا ويشرفنا أن ندعو فخامتكم لزيارة مملكة البحرين، مؤكدين على ما تفضلتم به من اقتراحات حول لجان التعاون التي ستكون بإذن الله الآلية المناسبة إلى مزيد من التطوير والتقدم في المجالات المذكورة. أشكركم على دعوتكم وحسن استقبالكم. شكراً فخامة الرئيس.
Then, His Majesty the King and the Turkmen President witnessed the signing of a number of agreements and memorandums of understanding between the two sides. An MOU between the Central Bank of Bahrain, CBB, and the Central Bank of Turkmenistan. An agreement between the Bahraini and Turkmen governments on a reciprocal exemption from visa requirements for holders of diplomatic and private passports and services. A memorandum of understanding between the governments of Bahrain and Turkmenistan on the women affairs field. A memorandum of understanding between the governments of Bahrain and Turkmenistan on developing cooperation in the transportation field. A memorandum of understanding between the governments of Bahrain and Turkmenistan on e-government cooperation. A memorandum of understanding in the education field between the two countries' ministers of education. A memorandum of understanding on cooperation in cultural field. A memorandum of understanding between the two countries' ministries of youth and sports affairs on sports cooperation. A memorandum of understanding on cooperation in the tourism field. His Majesty the King congratulated the Turkmen President on signing the agreements and MOUs that will be a new beginning in the course of bilateral relations. After the Memorandum of Understanding signing ceremony, the President of Turkmenistan gave a speech welcoming His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa and expressed appreciation for His Majesty for accepting the official invitation to Turkmenistan. He noted that today's meeting discussed a wide range of issues related to bilateral relations and means of development to meet the available possibilities and ensure the development of a long-term cooperation between Bahrain and Turkmenistan and achieve joint goals. He added that the two countries confirmed during the meeting their desire to develop political, commercial, and economic relations on both regional and international levels. The Turkmen president added that one of the main topics of discussion is the cooperation between Turkmenistan and Bahrain in the field of foreign policy. He said that Bahrain and Turkmenistan share common principles on the main current political issues, the first of which is to strengthen the system of security and stability in the world, Central Asia, and the Middle East, where they both express belief that ensuring a lasting peace in the world is through political mechanisms and diplomatic methods. He noted that Bahrain and Turkmenistan are witnessing a wide range of developments and that they both have vast natural resources and a good geographical location, which provides opportunities for mutual cooperation in the economic and commercial fields, which would create an appropriate platform for the effective exchange of experiences, noting the promising cooperation in the sectors of economy, agriculture, telecommunications, refining industry, and the petrochemical industry. The Turkmen president noted that the construction and modernization work on the port of Turkmenbashi on the Caspian coast of Turkmenistan, stressing that the logistical link between this port and the ports of Bahrain will become a promising project in increasing trade exchange. In this regard, he stressed that it is time to take a decision on the establishment of the Bahrain-based Joint Governmental Committee for Economic Cooperation and proposed the establishment of the Bahrain-based Turkmen Business Council. The Turkmen president expressed his appreciation to the Kingdom of Bahrain for its support of the Turkmen draft resolution on the World Cycling Day and wishing the Kingdom of Bahrain further progress, prosperity under the leadership of His Majesty the King. The Turkmen president then bid His Majesty the King farewell.
للتعبير لكم أولا عن شكرنا وتقديرنا على دعوتكم الكريمة لنا لزيارة تركمانستان الشقيقة وعلى كرم الضيافة وحسن الاستقبال معربين عن إعجابنا بالعادات والتقاليد المترسخة في هذا البلد العزيز والتي نحرص عليها ونتمسك بها في بلدنا وبين أبناء شعبنا وإننا إذ نقدر ما لمسناه خلال المباحثات من اهتمام مشترك لتطوير العلاقات الثنائية والارتقاء بها إلى أفضل المستويات بما يخدم مصالح البلدين والذي يعود بالنفع والفائدة على الشعبين الشقيقين لنعرب عن ثقتنا بأن مباحثاتنا المثمرة والبناءة وما تم التوقيع عليه من اتفاقيات ومذكرات تفاهم تشمل مختلف مجالات التعاون المشترك ومنها المجالات الدبلوماسية والصناعية والتجارة والمال والنفط والغاز والتربية والتعليم والنقل والثقافة والسياحة والرياضة والحكومة الإلكترونية وغيرها سيكون لها مردودات إيجابية وعميقة في تعزيز العلاقات الثنائية متطلعين هنا إلى المزيد من اللقاءات بين المختصين في البلدين لوجود فرص كبيرة للتعاون في مختلف المجالات ولما لها من دور كبير في دفع عجلة التعاون الاقتصادي والتجاري والاستثماري وفي هذا الإطار فإننا حرصنا على تواجد نخبة من رجال الأعمال البحرينيين خلال هذه الزيارة للقاء مع نظرائهم التركمانيين وبحث الفرص المتاحة للتعاون التجاري والاستثماري ولا شك أن إقامة المشاريع الاستثمارية وتنظيم المعارض والمنتديات الاقتصادية وتبادل الزيارات له دور كبير في تعزيز هذه المصالح المشتركة ويسهم في زيادة حجم التبادل
التجاري ليس بين البحرين وتركمانستان فحسب، وإنما بين تركمانستان ودول مجلس التعاون لدول الخليج العربية كمنظومة اقتصادية كبرى وسوق استثمارية واسعة. وإننا إذ ننوه بأن هذه الزيارة والمباحثات المشتركة حول كل ما يخدم العلاقات بين بلدينا وما يهمهما من قضايا تؤكد أن المستقبل واعد بمزيد من النمو والازدهار لعلاقاتنا الثنائية، فإنه ليسرنا دعوة فخامتكم لزيارة مملكة البحرين لبحث المزيد من فرص التعاون المشترك ومواصلة البناء على ما نتوصل إليه من نتائج واتفاقيات، وشكرا لكم. شكرا.
اشترام على سريع شونشينم onun ne alcenavi bahreni ve parsa ne hamad bin isa al halifani bedene türk mesanın bitavuk dem odulun sıralamak para dem karara geldi.
فخامة الأخ الرئيس، نشكر فخامتكم جزيل الشكر على منحنا وسام الحياد رفيع المستوى الذي نتشرف بقبوله بما يحمله من رمزية وطنية ومعاني عميقة تؤكد على أهمية ما يربط بلدينا من علاقات ثنائية في كافة المجالات والارتقاء بها إلى أفضل المستويات. ونشكركم مرة أخرى على هذه البادرة الكريمة التي نقدرها لكم ولشعبكم الكريم أشد تقدير، ونؤكد لكم بأنها ستكون محل امتنان واعتزاز كبير لدينا في البحرين. شكراً.
His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa visited today the shrine of the former president of Turkmenistan, Safar Murad Turkmen Basha, and the Turkmen Bashi Mosque, accompanied by Deputy Chairman of the Cabinet of Ministers of Turkmenistan and Foreign Affairs Minister Rashid Miridau, and the Mufti of Turkmenistan, Sarayev Shari Jildi. At the beginning of the visit, His Majesty the King placed a wreath at the tomb of the late president. His Majesty then toured the mosque, where he viewed the unique architectural designs of the mosque, which reflect the beauty of authentic Islamic architecture. His Majesty prayed in the mosque and listened to a brief from the Mufti of Turkmenistan about the stages of the establishment of the mosque and its role in the service of Quran memorization, recitation, and the promotion of religious sciences and Islamic culture. His Majesty praised the efforts of those who are working on in the mosque, wishing them success.
Thank you.
His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa visited today the Independence Tower in the Turkmen capital, Ashgabat, alongside the Deputy Premier and Foreign Affairs Minister, Rashid Mirdiyev. During His Majesty's visit to Turkmenistan, where he was received and welcomed by the Governor of Ashgabat Municipality, Shah Mohammed. At the beginning of the visit, His Majesty placed a crown of flowers and planted a tree in the name of Bahrain. His Majesty then toured the facilities of the tower and its content of artwork reflecting the different stages of the country's history and its cultural achievements. His Majesty the King expressed his appreciation for the efforts made by Turkmenistan, led by the President Gurbanguly Berdimuhamedow, in highlighting the cultural, historical, and touristic features of the country and wish them further success. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received yesterday at his residence in the Turkmen capital, Ashgabat, Bahraini businessman delegation that is accompanying His Majesty on the state visit. His Majesty the King lauded the pioneering role played by the Bahraini businessmen in supporting the development march of the kingdom's economy and its leading achievements in the fields of trade, industry, and investment. His Majesty the King also noted Bahrain's keenness on providing a commercial environment, facilities, legislations, and developed infrastructure that guarantee the success of investments on its soil and enhance its status as an important center of world trade. His Majesty the King expressed his appreciation for the economic and trade efforts in the kingdom through the visits to the brotherly and friendly countries, in addition to developing joint relations through establishing projects in the fields of investment and economy, aspiring that the Bahraini businessmen meetings with the Turkmen counterparts during this visit will open new horizons of economic cooperation and exchange of expertise that will contribute in increasing trade exchange between the two countries. For their part, the Bahraini businessmen expressed their sincere thanks and gratitude to His Majesty the King for his wise directions and support for holding economic partnerships with their counterparts from different parts of the world. They briefed His Majesty the King on the economic and business forum that was held with the Turkmen side and the trade agreements signed between the two sides during the forum that will contribute in supporting and promoting trade and economic cooperation between Bahrain and Turkmenistan. They also expressed their sincere pride in the support of His Majesty the King for the trade and economic sector in Bahrain and His Majesty's constant keenness on boosting the role of the private sector in the economic progress of the kingdom. They also underscored the importance of His Majesty the King's state visit to Turkmenistan, pledging to continue with their efforts to enhance the growth of the national economy. His Majesty the King hosted a dinner banquet in honor of the Bahraini business delegation. He wished them success in their meetings with the Turkmen counterparts in the interest of enhancing the bilateral relations and cooperation at various levels. On the sidelines of His Majesty the King's state visit to Turkmenistan, the Bahraini-Turkmen Business Forum was held yesterday evening in the capital, Ashgabat. The Minister of Industry, Trade and Tourism, Mr. Zayed bin Rashid Zayani, was the keynote speaker at the forum, which resulted in the signing of a number of memorandums of understanding between Bahrain and Turkmenistan. Al-Zayani said that the Kingdom of Bahrain, led by His Majesty the King, has outlined the future of Bahrain's national economy until 2030, based on the three principles of sustainability, competitiveness, and justice, and the shifting from an economy dependent on oil revenues to a more competitive and productive economy. He added that Bahrain has made strides over the past decade through the efforts of the government under the leadership of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister and with the support of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince for the implementation of many mega development projects since the 60s, as Aluminium Bahrain or ALBA, investing in banking, technology, and telecommunications, promoting the kingdom as a leading regional hub. The forum was significantly attended by officials from the public and private sectors in both countries. The forum also included a discussion panel on the opportunities of the Turkmen private sector in Bahrain, followed by a discussion session of the Turkmen side, which came under the title of Trading Opportunities in Turkmenistan. Meanwhile, a number of agreements and MOUs were signed between the Kingdom of Bahrain and Turkmenistan in various fields on the sidelines of His Majesty the King's visit to Ashgabat. The Gulf Petrochemical Industry Company, GPIC or GEPIC, signed a memorandum of understanding with the National Gas Company of Turkmenistan, Turkmengaz, to study petrochemical projects. A second memorandum of understanding was also signed with Turkmen state-owned company, Turkmenhimia, in the field of fertilizers. The signing ceremony was attended by Oil Minister Sheikh Mohammed bin Khalifa Al Khalifa and the Minister of State and Turkmen Gaz Chairman Mirat Arshiev. Bahrain Chamber of Commerce and Industry, BCCI, also signed a memorandum of understanding with the Turkmen Chamber of Commerce and Industry in order to develop horizons of cooperation and partnership between the two chambers, in addition to enhancing coordination between both sides and exchanging of expertise and economic information. On the sidelines of the Bahraini Turkmen Business Forum, Bahrain Chamber of Commerce and Industry, the BCCI, participated in the exhibition of the members of the Union of Industrialists and Entrepreneurs of Turkmenistan, which was held at the premises of the Turkmenistan Chamber, marking the 11th anniversary of the establishment of the union. The delegation toured the exhibition was briefed on the distinctive feature of Turkmenistan's industrial and economic projects that constitute an investment opportunity for Bahraini business. The chairman of the Turkmenistan Chamber briefed the Bahraini businessman delegation on the most prominent features of the exhibition and the products that reflect the history of the Turkmen Industrialists Union and entrepreneurs. The Minister of Foreign Affairs, Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed bin Mohammed Al Khalifa, met with the Deputy Chairman of the Cabinet of Ministers and Minister of Foreign Affairs of Turkmenistan, Rasit Miredov, on the sidelines of the official visit of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa to Turkmenistan. The Minister of Foreign Affairs expressed that the people of Bahrain value the warm hospitality that His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa and his accompanying delegation received during their visit to Turkmenistan. He added that this visit reflects the development of relations between Bahrain and Turkmenistan and that it will bolster the relations between the two countries at all levels for the common interest of both sides and their people in light of the positive outcomes and the agreements that have been signed. The minister also affirmed the keenness of the kingdom to continue joint coordination for their mutual benefits and for the establishment of peace and security across the globe. For his part, Mr. Meredov hailed the bilateral relations, which are constantly developing at all levels. He also affirmed the keenness of Turkmenistan to enhance its relations with Bahrain and to invest all opportunities for further cooperation between the two countries. He also praised the role played by the kingdom in establishing peace and security in the region, wishing Bahrain further progress and prosperity. The Minister of Industry, Commerce and Tourism, Zayed bin Rashid Al-Zayani, met at the Turkmen capital, Ashgabat, the Deputy Prime Minister for Foreign, Commercial and Economic Affairs, Cheri Galjov, and the Minister of Trade and Foreign Economic Relations, Amandordi Janov, in the presence of the President of Bahrain Chamber of Commerce and Industry, Samir Nas, and the Chief Executive Officer of Economic Development Board, Khalid Ramahi. Al-Zayani affirmed the Kingdom's keenness on developing relations with all world countries, particularly economic and commercial ties, noting the government's keenness on exerting economic partnerships and supporting effective cooperation to enhance the kingdom's national economy. During the meeting, the bilateral relations and means of bolstering cooperation in all fields have been discussed. The minister noted the kingdom's investment attracting economic environment and a regional location for many world companies. The Minister of Industry, Commerce and Tourism, Zayed bin Rashid Al-Zayani, held a meeting in Ashgabat, the capital of Turkmenistan, with Deputy Chairman of the Cabinet of Ministers of Turkmenistan, Shakiyev, in the presence of the Chairman of Bahrain Chamber of Commerce and Industry, Samir Nas, the Minister of Industry and Communications of Turkmenistan, Derhanov, and the Economic Development Board Chief Executive Officer, Khalid Ramahi. Al-Zayani affirmed Bahrain's keenness on developing its relations with the world, especially the economic relations, noting the government's continuous efforts to encourage economic partnerships and support effective cooperation to strengthen the national economy of Bahrain and to benefit from the expertise and resources of brotherly and friendly countries. During the meeting, the bilateral relations connecting Bahrain and Turkmenistan were highlighted and means to enhance cooperation mechanisms in all fields were discussed, especially those relevant industrial and investment fields. The meeting also stressed on the importance of bilateral visits and meetings in promoting and developing cooperation in various fields and benefiting from the Turkmen expertise and the available resources, especially in the field of industry, and noted the importance of exploring the opportunities of industrial investment in both countries. The Minister of Industry, Trade and Tourism, Zayed bin Rashid Al-Zayani, met in Turkmenistan today with Chairman of the Tourism Committee of Turkmenistan, S. Shokolov. During the meeting, a number of topics in the tourism sector were discussed and the programs that Bahrain is implementing according to its strategies, which were released to develop tourism, as well as its future aspirations and investment opportunities and possible cooperation opportunities with Turkmenistan. Zayani asserted that cooperation opportunities are open between the two countries in the field of tourism investments, noting that the potential of Turkmenistan could form a bridge to activate a cooperation within the framework of the historic visit of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa to meet the aspirations of the leaders of the two friendly countries. His Royal Highness the Deputy King Princess Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa met with His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa today at Ghadabiya Palace. During the meeting, their Royal Highnesses praised the achievements made during the era of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, which strengthened the regional and global role of Bahrain and promoted its relations with the world countries. They affirmed that the kingdom uses its modern renaissance as a solid foundation, which started during the era of the late Emir His Highness Sheikh Isa bin Salman Al Khalifa, who made great achievements in the service of his country and his people. This development track has grown and achieved many qualitative jumps in the era of His Majesty the King. His Royal Highness the Deputy King reviewed with His Royal Highness the Prime Minister a number of issues related to regional and international developments and stressed that terrorism does not carry an identity but carries an ideology based on extremism and fanaticism.
Thank you.
His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa chaired the Cabinet's weekly meeting at Ghudaybiyah Palace today. And following the meeting, the Secretary General of the Cabinet, Dr. Yasser bin Isa Al Nasser, delivered the following statement. His Royal Highness praised the efforts of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa in promoting the Kingdom's relations with friendly countries and welcomed the visit of His Majesty the King to the UAE, where His Majesty met with the Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi and Deputy Supreme Commander of the UAE Armed Forces, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed Al Nahyan and the ruler of Ajman and member of the UAE Supreme Council, His Highness Sheikh Ahmed bin Rashid Al Naimi, and witnessed the opening ceremony of the Special Olympics World Games 2019. His Royal Highness also welcomed His Majesty the King's visit to Turkmenistan, where he met with the President of Turkmenistan, Gurbanguly Berdimuhamedow, affirming that His Majesty's visit to friendly countries promotes the relations and cooperation between them and supports investment opportunities. The Cabinet condemned the terrible terrorist attacks on innocent worshippers in two mosques in New Zealand, which they described as a heinous and a vicious attack on innocence, an act that carries all forms of hatred, extremism, and terrorism. The Cabinet expressed its sincere condolences to the government and the people of New Zealand and stressed the need to stand up against all forms of fanaticism, extremism, hatred, and terrorism, and to spread the message of tolerance and respect for religions. His Royal Highness directed to study the implementation of 11 housing, health, social, and infrastructure projects and services for the citizens, which target a number of areas including Al-Malkiya, Karzakan, Sharakan, and Jid Ali. His Royal Highness also directed 5 ministries, including the Ministry of Housing, the Ministry of Works and Municipal Affairs and Urban Planning, the Ministry of Health, the Ministry of Electricity and Water Affairs, the Ministry of Labor and Social Development, to hand in a report to the Cabinet regarding those projects. His Royal Highness directed that the construction of units and housing projects coincides with the utilities and facilities necessary to meet citizen needs in these cities and large housing projects. He also directed that the enlargement of housing units to ensure the comfort of citizens, which is the main goal of the government. His Royal Highness also directed the ministers to complete the infrastructure work in a Ramli housing project in preparation for the distribution of housing units and granting them to beneficiaries in accordance with establishing standards and seniority. The Cabinet reviewed the 2018 preliminary results of the National Health Survey. His Royal Highness said the Prime Minister directed the Ministry of Health to develop programs and policies that reduce premature deaths due to chronic diseases such as heart disease, diabetes, cancer, and respiratory diseases, and increase awareness on the risks of these diseases and their causative factors. His Royal Highness also directed to benefit from the results of the survey in developing future health policies and strategies, and directed to refer the results to the National Information Commission. The Cabinet approved the draft main system project of the Arab Group for Space Cooperation, which aims to encourage and activate joint Arab space cooperation in all space fields and exchange expertise between member states. The Cabinet referred a memorandum of understanding for cooperation in the field of civil space between the National Space Science Agency and the United Kingdom Space Agency. The Cabinet approved a memorandum of understanding between the Ministry of Health and the Prince of Songkhla University in Thailand, which aims to encourage cooperation between the two sides in training and referral of patients and the visiting doctor program. The Cabinet referred to the Legal and Legislative Affairs Ministerial Committee a memorandum of understanding between the Supreme Council for Environment and the Saudi Wildlife Authority. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa received today in Ghudaybiyah Palace the chairman of the Bahrain Red Crescent Society, Sheikh Khalid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, and members of the Board of Directors. His Royal Highness affirmed that Bahrain is proud of the honorable charity and humanitarian work record, which reflects the Bahraini society's belief in the values of solidarity. He noted that the world is facing challenges that require the efforts of organizations and societies such as the Bahrain Red Crescent Society, which represents the values of solidarity and brotherhood. His Royal Highness praised the generous spirit of the people of Bahrain, noting that Bahraini people were raised on doing good deeds in accordance with the Islam and Bahraini values. He expressed appreciation for the late chairman of Bahrain Red Crescent Society, His Highness Sheikh Abdullah bin Khalid Al Khalifa, and his role in promoting the society's regional and international role. His Royal Highness asserted the government's keenness on supporting charity work, civil society organizations in a way that promotes its ability to deliver its humanitarian message, expressing thanks and appreciation for the chairman and members of the Bahrain Red Crescent Society for their efforts in achieving its goals, wishing them further success. For his part, Sheikh Khalid bin Abdullah Al-Khalifa and the board members expressed thanks and appreciation for His Royal Highness for his interest and support for the efforts of the society and the charity work sectors, affirming that his support is an incentive to serve the Bahraini community. The Representatives Council Speaker Fawzia bint Abdullah Zainal attended in the opening session of Family's Role in Consolidating the Values of Tolerance Conference, held under the patronage of the Chairwoman of the General Women's Union, President of the Supreme Council for Motherhood and Childhood, and Supreme Chairwoman of the Family Development Foundation at the UAE, Her Highness Sheikha Fatma bint Mubarak, and organized by the Ministry of Tolerance in Abu Dhabi. During the session, Zainal delivered a speech in which she affirmed the Kingdom's role in enhancing the values of tolerance and coexistence and the initiatives of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa to consolidate the approach of interdependence and rapprochement between communities and people. She asserted the importance of the conference for its role in reviewing humanitarian values and the prominent societal role of Sheikha Fatma bint Mubarak, noting that Islam has given the values of tolerance the status they deserve. Zainal also highlighted the contributions of Sheikha Fatma bint Mubarak and the model she represents in tolerance, noting the cooperation and Her Royal Highness's efforts in the field of women, motherhood and childhood. Under the patronage of the Royal Guard Commander, His Highness Major General Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, a reception and an honoring ceremony was held at Isa Air Base to a number of participants in the BDF Special Task Force that took part in the Restore Hope operation in Yemen within the Arab Coalition Forces led by Saudi Arabia. His Highness Sheikh Nasser deputized Deputy Commander of the Royal Guard, Major General Hamad Khalifa Al Naimi, to honor the participants. During the reception, Major General Hamad distributed the medals awarded by the Supreme Commander, His Majesty the King, to a number of officers, non-commissioned officers, and members of the BDF Special Task Force in appreciation of their sincere national efforts. The ceremony was attended by a number of senior BDF officers and the participants' families. The Minister of Oil, Sheikh Mohammed bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, nominated the Chief Executive Officer of the Electricity and Water Authority and Deputy Minister of Oil, Sheikh Nawaf bin Ibrahim Al Khalifa, to inaugurate the Middle East Energy Summit in its first edition in Bahrain as part of the 21st Middle East Oil and Gas Show, MEOS 2019. Sheikh Nawaf welcomed holding this important event in the kingdom, praising the important topics that will be addressed in the discussion sessions with the participation of speakers from various companies and institutions related to the energy sector, wishing all success to achieve the goals of the summit. Sheikh Mohammed bin Khalifa Al Khalifa stated that the world is witnessing many difficult challenges at various levels, including industries, transport and energy, which calls for developing safe, sustainable and modern strategies in line with the rapid developments in order to meet the growing demand for energy resources and maintain the growth and prosperity of the global economy. He stated that the importance of studying these challenges and turning them into investment opportunities for development towards progress, growth and prosperity is important for the sector.
It was an honor for me to be part of this great summit today. Sheikh Nawaf, we were honored with his presence with us today. This is the first of a long series of energy professional summits that we intend as the Society of Petroleum Engineers to conduct. The Society of Petroleum Engineers is known for its technical domain when it comes to oil and gas, and we are getting into more topics that basically impose challenges to the oil and gas industry, such as energy in general, sustainability, environmental and social development challenges. This event, as I said, it's inshallah series, will continue with us. We're very happy to host it initially in the Kingdom of Bahrain, hoping inshallah that it will continue with us to be part of the Middle East Oil Show every 2 years.
Temkin Labor Fund has announced that the institutional support and wage support programs have been restored and that a new formulation of the mechanism for training Bahrainis to make them the best choice in employment within private sector institutions has been implemented. This came during a press conference shared by the CEO of Temkin, Dr. Ibrahim Janahi, in the presence of a number of Temkin departmental officials who provided detailed explanations to various media representatives in Bahrain and identified the category to be targeted through the three programs. The e-government platform will be used to receive applications from individuals or companies.